Well, translations of books by other media tend to have mixed results. So Yenpress started publishing the manga Cirque du Freak based off a book series of the same name. The miss refers to that god-awful movie that should be burned at the stake. The hit is the manga adaptation, whose first arc, volumes 1 through 3, was oddly timed for volume 3 to come out when that terrible, terrible movie did. Terrible movie aside, let's move on to the main plot. The first three books make up the first arc, and the next three make up the second arc. The book series has four arcs, and from what has come out so far from Yum Press, it follows the books pretty well, and when it slightly bridges at times, it doesn't hurt. Darren Sean is your average 14-year-old boy, likes spiders, soccer, and hanging out with his best friends with no obviously evil tendency, Steve. Bored of living in suburbia, Steve and Darren obtain tickets to go to the Cirque du Freak, showing one night only. At the Cirque, Darren waits anxiously for the spider act shown on the flyer, but when it finally arrives, Steve looks at the performer with intense eyes. Steve rushes to the performer after the show and asks him to make Steve a vampire. The vampire refuses because Steve's blood shows he's clearly evil in a way that no one could possibly predict from Chapter 1. Darren rushes off frightened upon seeing this exchange, but cannot help but go back against all notions of common sense and steal the vampire's ultra-sexy spider. When showing off his new pet to Steve, Steve is fatally bitten and Darren must ask the vampire for help. He will help him, but at a cost. Darren must become a half-vampire and work as a vampire's assistant, and he is blooded on the spot. While at first resistant to the idea, Darren has a near incestual moment when he spots his sister's lovely, lovely jugular overflowing with rich, delicious blood, and accepts that he is turning into a vampire and agrees to leave his home forever to follow the vampire lest he hurt anyone precious to him. The beginnings of Darren's journey make up the first arc as he accepts his new fate and learns how to become a vampire. The next arc continues with Darren making his way to Vampire Mountain for a vampire gathering that occurs once every 12 years. In the second arc, Darren must undergo the vampire trials to prove his worth as a vampire while a new threat emerges, the Vampinese. In the future arcs, the clash between the vampires and the Vampinese will become the main driving force behind the story that takes place. I only know this from having read the novels, but assuming the manga follows the path as well as it has so far, you can only look forward to the story getting more engaging as it goes on. I don't usually address artwork, but it should be noted it improves drastically. Comparing full body introduction shots from Volume 1 to Volume 4 makes this obvious. This is not a shonen series based on screaming attacks or getting stronger to overcome new foes, but it's about following Darren's story as a half-vampire. Some chapters feel as though less action happened in them, but they seem a necessary balance and they still progress the story. Vampires have been rather annoying lately, and this series doesn't follow all of the classic vampire rules, but if you can get past that, at least it's not sparkling or angsting. Cirque du Freak is available from Yen Press. 5 volumes are out as of this review, and the series has completed its run in Japan, but is still being published in English. The original novels are available from Little Brown Books. I would call the Cirque du Freak manga volumes 1 through 5 a must-buy.